Hello, this is Ken Drews from the National Weather Service in Tucson. This video will explain what type of weather is in store for southeast Arizona this winter. However, you've probably heard a lot about El Niño lately, and it's probably a good idea to cover that topic first, then move on to the winter weather outlook. So what do climatologists and meteorologists mean when we talk about El Niño? Simply put, El Niño means that Pacific Ocean temperatures are warmer than normal. More specifically, the sea surface temperatures in a certain section of the eastern tropical Pacific, called the Niño 3.4 region, are greater than or equal to a half degree Celsius above normal. It's also a bit more complicated than that, as those warm ocean temperatures need to be observed for five consecutive overlapping three-month periods. On the other hand, when the ocean temperatures in that same region are at least a half degree Celsius colder than average, the phenomenon is called La Niña. As you can see from this graph, sea surface temperatures are highly variable. Most of the time, temperatures are within a half degree of normal, but every 3 to 5 years, a period of warmer or colder than normal temperatures occurs, marking an El Niño or La Niña, respectively. Each El Niño or La Niña episode usually lasts 9 to 12 months, but can persist even longer. They often begin to form during the summer, reach peak strength during the winter, and then decay during the late spring of the next year. El Niños can be classified as weak, moderate, or strong, depending on how much warmer than normal the sea surface temperatures are. The red circles show the six strong El Niños that have been observed since 1950. The green triangle highlights the last El Niño, which occurred 6 years ago and was of moderate intensity. There's a strong relationship between moderate and strong El Niños and wet winter weather in southeast Arizona. So why does this relationship exist? These maps show the prevailing jet stream positions during El Niño on the top and La Niña on the bottom during the winter season. During an El Niño winter, the warmer ocean temperatures generally results in the southern track of the jet stream to predominantly favor the southern tier of the United States. This steers weather systems across our area and brings wetter than average weather to Arizona, especially southern Arizona. By contrast, La Niña winters are characterized by the jet stream being diverted away from Arizona, which usually results in a dry winter. So about how much precipitation would an average winter bring? Shown here are those precipitation totals for selected locations in southeast Arizona. December through February totals are shown on the left. March precipitation is added into the totals on the right, since precipitation during El Niño winters usually persists into spring. As shown, most valley locations normally receive 3 to 5 inches during the 4-month period. Kitt Peak and other high elevation sites typically receive even more winter precipitation. The average December through March precipitation is still shown on the right, but is compared to the winter of 2009 to 2010 on the left. As you can see, all of the locations shown here were wetter than normal 6 winters ago. Again, the average December through March precipitation is shown on the right, but now is compared to the average precipitation that occurred during the corresponding 4-month periods during the 6 strong El Niño winters. The average for these 6 winters is nearly double of a normal winter total at all of the locations shown here. Taking into account the meteorology involved and what history has taught us, it should be no surprise that the official forecast for this winter is for southeast Arizona to likely be wetter than average. The probability of being wetter rises to over 60% by the time we get to the January through March outlook shown here on the right. With more days, with rain and clouds likely, it stands to reason that the daytime high temperatures may be cooler than average. On the other hand, clouds and wind can help keep overnight temperatures from getting too cold. The temperature outlooks from the Climate Prediction Center favor cooler than normal temperatures, especially as we get into early 2016, but still only slightly. In summary, since we are looking at an El Niño this winter, we should expect a wetter than normal winter with plentiful mountain snow. Since we are likely to have a number of winter storms move over the region, the elements could also come together to create snow in the valleys at some point. However, smaller daily temperature ranges should prevail with warmer overnight lows and cooler daytime highs. Finally, these winter storms often bring bouts of very strong winds with them. While winter rains and mountain snows are beneficial for groundwater levels, they can also cause a few problems. It's always best to be prepared so you're not caught off guard. For example, make sure your home and vehicles are ready for the wet or snowy weather. Repair faulty roofs and trim trees around your home. Carry a winter survival kit in your vehicle and ensure your vehicle is ready for winter, especially if traveling over high terrain or to other parts of the country. Remember some of the same safety tips you observed during the monsoon, such as staying away from downed power lines and turn around, don't drown. Thanks for listening to this presentation. For additional information about climate prediction, El Niño, winter weather, and preparedness, see the websites listed here. Many of these are linked from the National Weather Service Tucson website, weather.gov/Tucson. Stay safe this winter.